How do you feel right now, Spike?
Half asleep.
Half asleep.
Yeah. My brain's like half here, half not.
How's it going, Eddie?
Oh, perfect. Not a problem in the world. What do you mean? Perfect. Everything's fine. Everything's going according to the plan we had. You just write down your goals, and we had a goal of, you know, building this bike in a month. And everything's gone perfectly smooth. Parts showed up right on time. Coatings, everything came out perfect. So I don't see why we can't make it there in 6 hours.
So guys, what's today? The 3rd? 4th? Oh, not good. The 1st of October, which is in less than, like, I don't know, it's like 3 weeks away. We're gonna build this bike, compete. It's gonna be extreme, stressful, but it is what it is, because we got to come and kill.
Let's ride, let's slide, we up, yep. Let's ride, let's slide, we up, we gone. Let's slide, let's ride, we up, where my dirt bag players at. Let's ride, let's slide, we up. Hit up the homie Mikey, then I roll up the dirt bag. Customize the hall, got the shiny.
Need that far from the ABS to come out and cover it. I'm thinking we can cut from right here to like right here, cut all this off, and then we could blend this into one piece. We could even eliminate that style line right here, this one, cut this whole shit off right here, take this whole thing out. We gotta take this piece out and then have it flow into it. And cover this whole piece, mold it, and then now eliminate the difficulties that we're gonna have in this little area of mold. So we could have it come into here, we'll bridge it, we can leave this whole thing, and then we'll cut this into it. And then should we do a tank that goes into the side cover like how we do it, or should we have it sit over the top and eliminate the hole? See that? There's a steel tank. See that one right there? Yeah. Where's that tank that's here right now that's not body worked? We came up with ideas of this bike, but you can't really tell till we really start getting into it. We're gonna bust the engine out today. We're gonna take out every chrome piece possible. Anything that we could eliminate on this bike. We're gonna keep the ABS, because it's a cool feature. We're gonna cut the neck. So we have tons and tons of work to do. We're gonna do everything we can in-house. We're gonna have to just send out for powder coat. Everything else we're capable of doing. Everything else we've been in the routine of getting it ready for this build, but we're nowhere close. But we can do it. Definitely we can do it. This is gonna be our new style of a kingtail. That's what we're designing right now. That's why we could have easily just came and just reuse our recipe. No problem, shut the show down, kill it. Another kingtail. But we're gonna switch it up like we normally do, and we're gonna take it to the next level. It's a cool bike that I had picked up. It was a police edition. 114 M8. I ripped it around town, took it to different states, had a ball with it, and now it's time to tear it down. Doing this one-off everything. The only thing that's not one-off is gonna be the front fender, but we'll do something to make it look one-off. We'll cut it, we'll do something. We have a straight line right there as well, and then this is going to taper into it, so this is going to be this corner will be eliminated.
Exactly, because this is going to roll into it anyway, so yeah. Like you're saying, if we get rid of that piece that's going to go here is actually going to flow into it.
Yeah. Yeah.
However it flows into it.
Yeah, probably. You prefer to do a one-off one, or do you want to just grab some that are already like pre-cut and that'll be easier to get into?
It'd be easier to do the pre-cut ones, like faster.
Yeah.
But we can make a custom one. Then it would be like cut right there and I'll box it in.
I don't know what's going on with all you multi-million dollar energy drink companies, but no one's showing us love. All right, Bang, you want to show us some love? We're banging out bikes. Banging out bikes with Bang. I don't know, that was pretty good. I think that was better right off the top of my head than a lot of other people that you guys be sponsoring. Just throwing it out there. Do I gotta show some skin? I don't know. I don't know, Bang. Can I get a couple cases at least? Something? That would be something.
Is that good, Mike?
It's amazing. It tastes like unicorn pee.
I love Bang. I love Bang.
Let's show you those side covers.
Unicorn.
Coming with the heat, and the heat is King Tails. We're evolving, we're not stopping, we're coming with the heat once again. Next level with it. It's our new one. Sneak preview of the bike that's gonna be whipping that ass at the Super Show. Bike basically and tore it into pieces. We ain't going nowhere, we can't be stopped now. We have like 20 days to build a bike, and I'm not telling anybody, but I'm going on vacation next week for 4 days. So when I get back, that means no days off and working 15 hours a day. You nervous about getting this bike done?
Me?
Yeah.
No.
Hey, Eddie, got a little nervous bone in your body about getting this bike done?
Me?
Yeah. I know. We knew this was coming. There was no reason to do this like this. We had more than enough time, but we're doing all kinds of other shit too. We have four Thursdays. We got it. Maybe we got it. All these parts are gonna be one off. Nothing's gonna fit at all. I just realized how off the rear end was right now. So that kind of worried me. Like the rear end is gonna have to be fully cut, chopped, screwed. That wheel mock-up divin' wasn't even able to mock up, not even a little bit. We have a good recipe on the King Tails we've been using, but hey, why did we wanna like go by the book that we created? We wanna make it more difficult and cooler. I just figured like the soft tail builds after we're done with them, they're huge, they look monster-like. They're a beast, you know? They're nothing small about them. So I figure if we do it out of a Road King, that will be a monster. That thing's gonna be huge. It's gonna be a tank coming down the block. So we have to set the bar higher every time. How do we outdo ourselves? By creating a whole new King Tail setup. It's gonna be insane. We're coming with the heat. like not even close. So we need to jack this up and line it up to the back of this swing arm right here so we can get an accurate measurement. It's gonna go a little taller, but the fender's gonna sit way over here. I mean, that's how it's gonna sit.
5 inches, 5 inches. It's gonna sit down in the front a little bit, it'll be fine.
So what we're gonna do right now, I'm gonna drill the back, make sure it's fucking straight, and just drill them in. But these are just gonna be right here just so they could fill it in with fiberglass.
I'm gonna drill it where it's at right now.
Yeah, but just make sure it's straight. I can look at it right now and I can see that it's kicked this way. So that front hole is too high. And then drill those plates all right here, and then so pop it off so we could send it to get stripped. It's the 12th. We have like, I don't know, 14 days. 14 days to build the bike. I woke up, I feel like shit. I'm so fucking sick right now. I can't really be next to the guys because I don't want to get them sick. I tried to take a nap and I just kept thinking about what we need to do to the bike. We're ordering everything we possibly can, trying to get as much shit as we can. I'm looking at the bike and seeing the layout finally, and it's gonna be massive. It's gonna be super sick. We definitely got days to go. I got like four people dancing, and we got getting this bike that we gotta do like in 14 days, Eddie. It's fun and games till we're close to that. We're building everything possibly we can right now. The fenders are like, the stuff that we're using, you just can't buy it. It's all one off. It's all, we never done it before. We could have easily just did the previous recipe and been a walk in the park, but we're choosing the difficult route, and that's why we continue to grow. Except Eddie. Eddie's the same size since I met him. If anything, he's shrunk.
Mom stopped buying me the Pedia shirts.
Eddie used to be taller when he had hair. It like came straight forward too. Like you had no hairdo. What was the hairdo you had going on? Remember
hair.
You had a lineup with like just the front, like the front look. Like a Phineas.
I never had that.
He had like a Phineas and Ferb look. We're on a deadline, we have tons of stuff to do, and we have no headlight or anything for this build. I don't want to do like a regular bucket light because that's all we do all day long. Everybody does it. So I got to think outside of the box. I have this bracket that I've been having for years. I found it in someone's garage. It's made out of aluminum, so it should cut really clean. Super light, durable. It's not going to work whatsoever for what we're doing, but these holes, this bracket right here, I could get one cut, but by the time we try to get one cut, work it all out, go back and forth, we're gonna waste so much time. And I feel like I could just make this thing work. So right now, I think I'm just gonna cut it like this, and then we'll go back to it. So it's either it's gonna work, or I'm gonna ruin this part. I've been taking antibiotics all day because I'm so sick, but it's starting to work now. I haven't eaten anything besides a half a donut. It has this weird indention right there, so I'm just gonna run that indention line and keep it like I did it on purpose. This is like off the fly shit, and then watch, everybody's gonna be like, dude, where y'all get that at? And I'm like, I was sick as f*** one day and was thinking I'll make it because why not?
sun. I weld that up right there, grind it out. We won't never tell I done cut it and flipped it. We gotta let the Dremel cool down and then I'll cut this one. Seen it first at Dirtbag, so when everyone starts copying me, don't be like, oh damn, look what they came out with. No, we did it. We're trendsetters. We set the bar high. You guys are gonna do it after us. It's all good. I ain't tripping, but just know it came from us. You guys already know we have how many days left? 12? 11. 11 days left. 11 days. Started off with, you guys already know, our emblems, Michael Lugo design, Harley Davidson motorcycle, whatever you want to call it. This is our design. If you see this on a tank, it's because we did it, all right? You can't buy these because these are just for our full builds. So don't ask, please, because I'm going to say no. Started off with a flat piece. Boom, boom, flat. And then we start to concave it in, compare it for the fitment of the tank. So I'm gonna hand pound it till it fits the tank properly and we don't get no rocking on it. Right now, I got a little bit more rocking. So I'm gonna pull down these two top corners down. We got tons of work to do. Now we're just going down the list and whatever the hell we need to do, someone's gonna grab the job and knock it out. When you see the whiteboard in here, it mean we're getting close. Right now, there's so much shit to do that we already know what to do. So, but the whiteboard means that we're coming down to an end and we're nowhere near whiteboard status. So we're just gonna keep pushing. And I'm gonna keep a little hammering this thing till I get it right. Before, guys, cut it all up, got the shit welded up. I'm just body working the metal a little bit so it could look nice. This is gonna be the bracket for those Baja lights. That shit is gonna be crazy when it's done. I cannot wait to see it. See, like, I'm the only one here, or well, the only one that's gonna know what it looks like because I just envisioned the shit in my head. So, super sick. So now, I just gotta drill this right here so I can fit that bracket. And then I have to plumb this. I have to put wires all through this where you can't see it. So that should be fun. There's gonna be one center wire, but I just drop it down straight into the frame. This one's gonna be easy into the frame. This one's gonna be the difficult one. I gotta make this loop somehow in there nice. I'm probably gonna drill it and then put, oh no, I can't drill it. Cause I'm gonna see the hole on the other side. I'm gonna have to tap something right here. Some type of, something to hold these wires in place so you can't see them. I don't know, I'll figure it out when I get there, but definitely gonna be badass. Can't wait.
Still don't got wheels or nothing. We're missing a lot of shit still. Okay. And none of the parts are here. We got like some. I gotta use this hole, you gotta use this knot. So I gotta mock up everything on this frame because the other frame's not ready.
We have 10 days left. 10 days, guys, to build a bike, and look what I'm working on. Some raw ass handlebars. I was back against the wall and could not figure out the life of me to find these fittings I needed to go internal clutch and internal brake, right? So I was like, what the hell am I gonna do? These fittings we normally use, they've discontinued them. And we used up all of our fittings we had in stock. Then we were gonna go with the alternate one that we found that most likely our competition is using, and they were out of stock. And I was, could not think of what to do. We had a gentleman stop by the shop named Jody, and he was like, yeah, I build bikes. I was like, yes, what's up, bro? Come by, swing, hang out, you know? And I forgot he was coming by, and he came over today. I mentioned to him, I was like, yeah, man, we got this build, and we got 10 days, we're nowhere near it. We just need these brake lines, these fittings. And he said, I think I have some. Out of everybody in the United States that would have these things in stock, because we couldn't find them everywhere sold out, we had what we needed. I couldn't believe it. He was like, yeah, I think I have some of those at my shop. So I went over there. His shop was badass. He had I think it was a 48 Chevy truck with a 6.0 LS inside of it. It was insane, natural patina. So shout outs, bro. I appreciate you. I know you're watching. I appreciate you. Saved the day, came through, and now I'm getting these hand controls. We already wired them, have all electronics already through them. So now we're just gonna drill the handlebars so we can have internal clutch and brake, because nobody wants to see those cables. So now I'm pumped up, hell yeah. I'm gonna work late tonight because we need to drill these bars, start working on them, because we're gonna paint them. We're not gonna powder coat them. We could have easily powder coated them, but everybody does that. A paint job that's gonna match the whole bike. So if we paint them, we got two-tone them. And then if we two-tone them, we got to pinstripe them. And if we pinstripe them, we might as well drop shadow them and make them just insane. It's a lot of work that we have to do, and we're very, very far from it. The team's ready. We're here to f-ing get the job done. Everybody's handling business, you know? Everyone's doing a kick-ass job. This is gonna come in. Normally we flip this, but then we're really limited on adjustment of the bars. I wanted to loop it back in, but the fittings we have are straight fittings only. There's the fittings we normally use loop back in, and then we normally could use like this 90 fitting that would come in like that, but it's not gonna look as clean. For some reason that the parts that we normally use, they discontinued them. We have to switch it up. We ran bars like this straight into it, and it's a super clean, super, super clean. Anything happens, we can get to it really easily. We can move all this. So functionality is gonna work 110%, spot on. No problems, easy to bleed everything. But the downfall of this is that the tube's gonna come and you'll see like about an inch of the tube. That's the only downfall. I ran them opposite ways and did everything. This is the most functional way to do it. When you're running a housing like this, OEM housing, then I have more room in the hand controls to whip it around and have all kinds of fun with it and hide it and tuck it. But since we're running these sleek ones right here, we don't really have the proper room. And I don't want to smash the line and deal with it leaking the last couple days, the last day of a build. I want it to move and run smoothly, so I'm gonna go this route with it. So it'll still be super clean. All the cables will be tucked through the handlebars. You won't see them going out everywhere. Real little 1-inch piece and that's it. It'll look good. But yeah, man, 10 days away. Hey, what's today? Thursday? How many days we have?
We have
8 days?
7, 8 days, and whatever Saturday morning we get.
We got a full week, basically. We're not done tonight. We're still gonna go for a few more hours of fitment. Look at how it's coming out. We're finding center of this rear fender. We couldn't fit this till now because we need the rim and the tire mounted with all the parts, and we barely got the rims today. Shout out to my boy Jade, always helping us out, knocking it out. These deadlines are crazy, but gotta make it happen.
Got the one-off side covers. We're finishing up this fender. We're gonna fit it finally, and then we'll cut it to how we want it.
Sick.
Oh shit.
Damn. I've been getting bit up by mosquitoes.
We're gonna go most likely with some ARPs, and then I tapped it, but I don't feel, even if I put two more screws, I'm thinking I'll tap them, but it's aluminum. I feel like that headlight's too expensive to just to leave it with those taps, so I'm gonna put an ARP nut on it and match the hardware, bust this thing back down, and then we'll do some body work and make that bracket look pretty. Still fitting the body, it's looking amazing. Very, very happy and pleased. We're about to pour the seat pan, and then let it cure overnight, and then we can bust down and then back into paint and primer. Cutting the gun, we got six days left, and we have tons of work to do. But we're going. Look at that rear fender, amazing big boy right here. We got that bracket getting finally in the body right now. Been working on that bracket forever. We got Victor in the house, guys. I highly call backup. I like Vic. We need some backup. I had to call on professionals. We were gonna pour the seat pan, and I said, forget that. I'm gonna let Vic come down and do his magic, because we have no time for error.
No time for error. It's ready to be gone in 2 days.
Yes, sir. He's gonna come knock it out like he does all our other bikes. Only working with the best, guys. Only working with the best.
Yes.
Sheesh. Dropping some white. Fender dash and tank, so we can start the airbrushing. We got a lot of work to do, and we are behind, but we're not gonna stop. This bracket has been haunting us. Look at how nice it came out. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, guys, check it out. Pretty much just fingering it now, see if I can feel anything inside of the paint. Got like a little ding right there, gotta do a filler. Everything else is looking pretty good. We're gonna primer this now one more time, and then we'll shoot it black. To ride this into the show and shut it down, because it's truly amazing. I'm proud of the team. We're knocking it out of the park. We're a bunch of doers, you know what I mean? You know? It sits like that, you can see it. See, we missed a spot. Look at that. Now we gotta take this shit apart.
We got 3 days, okay? 3 days, I'm getting yelled at, and I got this, that's the frame, just baking like a chicken. Look at that, baking like a chicken, like a little warm turkey, okay? That's my wire harness, that's my motor, okay? And then those are the parts. Got all kinds of parts. Thank you.
pull this table out, and then one grabber from the front side, and another person grab the inside and pull it in.
Got it. So Diego, you're just gonna move the table. They're gonna pick it up, and you're just gonna move the table away from them.
Two days left, Mike, and he broke the bearing. Where's he at? Look at him.
Hey there, my name's Eddie. I build shit all day, but I really just record and talk shit.
Yes. Yes, I do. The struggle is real. Here you have Mike. Mike's a regular person, just like everybody else. He struggles. Let's watch him struggle. All right, guys, you've got it here. We've caught a Mike in the wild. Okay, you gotta be really quiet though. These things like to get real rowdy. All right, let's go approach him and see what he's doing. Ah, look at that. He's in his natural habitat, in the corner curled up. Look at him. Ah, shit, checking. Man, always on the phone, never on the grind. I don't know what today is. Today's Thursday, so we got today and tomorrow, okay? But we didn't sleep yesterday. I took my ass to sleep at like 2:30-ish by the time I got home. So this guy, well, you got your haircut. You woke up early then, huh?
Huh?
You woke up early?
Yeah.
Yeah, because he had a fresh cut, so I know he woke up. I thought he was going to sleep in late because he was already here. But nope, he came in and he looked all fresh, like he just showered. And
I had to wake up at 7.
Yeah.
I was so tired.
They let me sleep in. Hey, look at this guy. He looks all fresh. Look at that. He ain't tired or nothing.
I'm the real Shady.
He ain't tired or nothing.
So check it out, we made it, okay? No sleep, non-stop work, and we came with another just showstopper, guys. We got our new and improved King Tail, everybody. We are starting this off based off of a Road King frame, okay? So we started off with an M8 chassis and just ripped everything to shreds. No more bags, custom side covers, custom rear end, extended swing arm, suspension, chain drive, you name it, this bike has it. We have one-off pieces throughout the whole bike. We complement the bike with a Baja lights, but still with a Road King feel. Two fog lights, the main headlight. I love how it came out. We went with a wide rear tire, 23 in the front, and a wide rear tire, 21 in the back. Okay, so check it out, guys. We extended this rear end, pulled it back, and did a wide set tires on this, okay? 21 in the back, 23 in the front. These things, just because it's a 23, don't let it fool you. That's the size of a 26, okay, guys? And then for that 21 is the size of a 23. The tires are a lot taller, a lot wider, and I think it just fits the bike with that satin scheme and this abstract art. I'm just in love with it, man. We were completely out of the box on this one, and we wanted to come and shut this show down, and I think we did, guys. No competition whatsoever. Pretty much a crazy, crazy build out of my head to reality once again, guys. Once again. The heart and soul of Savage Cycles right here that no one knows about. Am I lying or not?
Not really though.
Oh, he said really though. Damn. We over here at Savage Cycles booth. We gotta come show support, show love.
Hey, this is a party.
Hey, get it off of him.
I sit on my bike.
Whatever.
I got the key.
Back to work, guys. We got a lot of work to do. We got a lot of cleanup to do. Mainly clean up. Look at right-hand drive right there. That's how you know. That's gonna cost me a lot of money. I was half asleep. I didn't sleep all week long. And I wanted to go home. Wrecked the whole chin spoiler. Hit it on the ramp going up the truck. Didn't air it up all the way. I want to blame Javi, but it's my fault, but Javi's influence, because I was completely fine doing my thing, and he said that the rear is going to hit, and I don't know, I lowered the front a little bit so it could tilt, and should never listen to somebody that short, and I straight wrecked the whole chin spoiler. And then you know what else he did, guys? He smashed the Kingtail's back fender unloading it.
That it was smashed already.
It wasn't smashed, it was probably dinged, oh, now it's smashed. Look at it, completely broke.
Nice. Hey, better this than the rear fender.
Yeah, 100%. We definitely cost the shop about $3,000 in damage on that show, easily, about three bands. But hey, players f*** up too, you know. Done cleaning up pretty much. We're closing the shop up and done working.
The guys f-ing killed it all week. We're gonna go have some fire ass food at my boy's restaurant, and then we're gonna go have some good activities after. So, you know, work hard, you gotta play hard. Let's go, guys.
Eating. What we eating?
What we eating?
What you gonna eat good?
He said I could supersize my Happy Meal. Bring that 10 piece, baby.
Small little hole in the wall that you guys don't know about, and you. If you're in Orange County, next to Knott's Berry Farm, you gotta try it out. It is amazing, you guys, peep it out.